Okay, for your lecture 8, word processing, we are going to move forward. Now, in this lecture, we are going to study about managing footers. Footers are basically the information that you provide at the bottom of your document. So, to be more precise, footer वो होता है जो आप information bottom of the document में provide करते हैं, जो कि एक image भी हो सकती है, copyright का information भी हो सकती है, and it can also be a date or number of the document or just the name of the topic that you are discussing in that document. Okay, so this is what footer is. So footer are text or image included at the bottom of the page. May repeat in all the page of the document. Now this is your choice. You can just repeat that footer in all the pages of the document, or you just can fix that footer to the one page of the document also. Okay, that is completely on you. Now here it says how to actually insert the footer. Click on the insert tab. You get this insert tab in your MS Word. Click over here. This I already told you, this complete thing is the ribbon. So in the ribbon, click on the tab that is named as insert. Then you will get this group which says header and footer. Over here, click on the footer. You will see a drop down list. Collection of predefined footers will be available there. Okay, you can just select among them and just can use it in your document. Okay, here is an activity that you can perform. If you have a computer system in your home and if you have your MS Office installed in there, you can just try this. Okay, then you have this assessment. I want you to do this assessment in your notebook. Okay, I want to see this in your notebook. Now you have your managing styles. So in the ribbon section only you have your style. Also, you can insert style. What is the style all about? Style or styles sets are predefined or customized option used for creating good looking professional documents with least effort. You can find a number of styles available within word processor that can be applied to the document. So what it says is you get different styles over here which are predefined. These are like templates that you can use. Okay, you can just use this, and this will be implemented on the document that you have created. Okay, you can just select among these and you can just work on your document. So for this you don't have to like create each and every style for the complete document. You can just go for it and just use any of these template predefined ones, and you can just create the document that would be really good looking and professional looking also. Okay, so here also you have this activity to perform the styles. You can just do it in your computer system if you have it in your home, and also I want you to do this fill in the blanks in your notebook. Now we have your document template. I have as I have already discussed about templates, templates are the pre-designed documents already present in your application. Okay, you can just download them from the web if you want to use something from the web, or you can use the template which are already there in your software. You just have to click them, just select them and just use it in your document. Okay, so templates or document templates refer to a sample fill in the blank document that can help in saving time. Okay, you just have to fill the information according to your document in that pre-designed template and just make your own document for that. Usually templates are customized document that may have sample, content, theme, etc. So what it consists of, wo consist karta hai samples already banaya hua document ka. ठीक है, templates में आपके already कोई पहले से document बने हुए होते हैं, उनके samples रहते हैं जिनको आप अपने document में merge कर सकते हैं. आप अपनी information उनकी इन्फॉर्मेशन से रिप्लेस कर सकते हैं, बट डिज़ाइन जो होगा उस टेम्पलेट का वो आपका फिक्स रहेगा जो पहले से ही डिज़ाइन हो रखा है. ओके, सो टू व्यू द टेम्पलेट अवेलेबल इन योर वर्ड प्रोसेसर व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज गो टू द फाइल न्यू एंड यू विल बी डिस्प्लेड विद डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टेम्पलेट ओवर देयर. ओके, लाइक दिस. ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज जस्ट क्लिक ऑन एनी ऑफ देम एंड यू कैन जस्ट स्टार्ट यूजिंग इट. ओके, Then over here, you can also download, as I have already told you, you can download the template as well from the web. You can just go to these website, office.com, office.microsoft.com, then you have the papermilestore.com, blogs.com and docstore. Okay, so you can access these website also. You will get different template, design template over there, and you can just download them also and use it in your own file. Then you have this activity, download the template from the internet and just use it in your document. Try this if you have your PC, and you can create the document that can be invoice, a letterhead, or a letter, or a PDF, anything that you want to use, and you can just put the information, the header, footer, and also you can use the template. Here's the fill in the blanks again. You can just use this fill in the blanks, just fill them and just write in your notebook. Now working with page and section break. Now this is something important, very important. The footer section, the header section, page breaks are very important. Okay, so page and section break can be used to separate document into sections. Obviously, if it says break, that means you're breaking something into sections, right? If you would like to start a new page in a document, you can use a page break. Agar aap ek naya document banana chahte hain, एक नया पेज आपके डॉक्यूमेंट में बनाना चाहते हैं, तो आप उसके लिए पेज ब्रेक यूज कर सकते हैं. टू सेपरेट अ सेक्शन इन अ डॉक्यूमेंट, यू कैन यूज द सेक्शन ब्रेक. अगर आपको कोई सेक्शन ब्रेक करना है, तो यू कैन यूज द सेक्शन ब्रेक. ओके, फॉर एग्जांपल, यू कैन ले आउट पार्ट ऑफ सिंगल कॉलम पेज एज टू कॉलम्स. यू कैन सेपरेट द चैप्टर एज सेपरेट सेक्शन इन योर डॉक्यूमेंट, सो दैट द पेज नंबरिंग फॉर ईच चैप्टर बिगिंस एट वन. यू कैन ऑल्सो क्रिएट द डिफरेंट हेडर एंड फुटर फॉर अ सेक्शन ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ टेक्स्ट बुक एंड यू क्रिएट डिफरेंट सेक्शन फॉर डिजिटल लिटरेसी, वर्ड प्रोसेसिंग, स्प्रेडशीट, एक्सेट्रा. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज द पेज ब्रेक एंड द सेक्शन ब्रेक. नाउ कम्स द पेज लेआउट. हाउ यू विल डू दैट? क्लिक ऑन द पेज लेआउट. हियर इज द टैब इन योर रिबन. क्लिक ऑन दिस टैब and click on break in the page setup group. Page setup group you have, go to break and you can use it. As a drop down list with option for different type of breaks will appear, and explanation would be given in front of it. Okay, you can just use it. Now this is how you'll get the explanation and the types of page break. You can select them, any of them, and just use it in your document. And if you want to, like, if you have inserted a page break and you want to remove it, you can simply just press delete on your keyboard and the section or page break would be removed. Okay, now you have this activity. Click on the page section and just try to insert the page break. Okay, and your assessment, that you have to do it in your notebook. Then you have your applying character formats. See, character format is the way you want your character to look like. Okay, if you are creating a text box with specific content, you need to use special formatting for some character. Character formatting can be applied to a single character or word. Okay, it can be applied to a single character. आप एक single character को भी वो format apply करा सकते हैं, या फिर एक पूरे word को भी apply करा सकते हैं. In this section, you will learn how to perform character formatting. Working with character formatting. To work with character formatting, open a new document in word processor. Type the following. You just have to type this information. You can just type any information actually. This is just an example of a write-up. You can just use this, or you can just type in on your you can just type any of your paragraph and then use the formatting in that. And now to make the changes, you may need to format the character as shown below. You will notice that some word of the paragraphs are in bold, some are in italics, and some are underlined. So, and also you will see subscript and superscript over there like this. So when you are using your formatting, everything would change like this. See, the font of this word have changed, this has highlighted, this color of this letter has changed, this has turned up into a bold letter. capital, and then again this is capital letter strike through like this. So this is called as character formatting. Okay, grow font, you can just increase the size of the font. Shrink font is used to decrease the size of the font. Strike through is to cut the font from the center. Subscript will get the number or the alphabet in the base of the letter or the character. Superscript, like you use in your maths, exponent, the power, the degree. So this is what it is, subscript. Okay, the subscript is for the base one, and superscript is for the power or the degree. Okay, super means at the top and subscript means at the bottom. Then you can change the cases: sentence case, lowercase, uppercase, capitalize each word, and toggle case. So here are formatting. Clear formatting, you just want to remove all the formatting that you have done. Then you have your highlight color. Text highlight, you can just use a highlighter like you use in your book to highlight some sentence. You can use highlighter over here also. Okay, the sentence that you are, you want to make it make some sentence visible, so you can just use this highlighter for that. Then you have your font color. You can use the font color, you can change the color of the font. Change case, you can just change the case. These are some of the cases which are listed here. Sentence case, on selecting this option of the drop down list, the first character of the word of the selected sentence would be capitalized. So as you all know, the first letter always start from capital. So in this, it would be sentence consists of the first character would be capitalized. Then you have your lowercase. Lowercase, you will sentence or the complete paragraph would change its case to lowercase. Then uppercase, everything would be capitalized. Then you have capitalized each word. If you want to capitalize each word by selecting this option from the drop down list, first character of each in the word of the selected sentence would be capitalized like this. Okay. Then you have your toggle case. On selecting this option from the drop down list, the small letter in the selected text will be converted into capital letters, and capital letters would be converted into small letters. So it would actually toggle. If the letter R in capital letter, that would turn to be a small one, and if it is in small, that would turn into the top one, the capital one. So now you have this activity. Perform the activities till you are confident. So if you have in your computer and you have your MS Office over there, you can just try to make the changes in the paragraph. You can just change the font face, you can change the size, the color, text, and change the case. Then you have this assessment. I want this fill in the blanks in your notebook. And then you have insert graphical object or illustration. How you can actually insert the graphics in your document, how you can insert the images in your document. So here are some of the website also provided here, from where you can actually download the clip arts. Clip arts are the vector form of the images that are provided in your MS Office, right? So to use this, you have to go to insert a clip art in the document, open the document, click on insert tab over here in the ribbon, and click on clip art, and you can use the clip art. Then you can just select the clip art and just click on it, and it is ready to be used in your document like this, right? So this was the here are the questions that you have to do, and also I have provided the assignment that you have to do in your notebook. Now the thing is, this was the theory part. Also you will be getting the practical view of this lecture in your next class. I'll be providing you a practical view of this complete lecture, in which you will get the practical knowledge on how you can actually perform all these steps in your software. Okay, so I want you to go through this lecture, and then at the end of this you will get this question. I want you to do it in your notebook, and I'll see you again in the next lecture now.